Attack at some stage, aren't we?
Yeah. I'm trying to see if I can get as far as I can do it.
It's about 3:30 in the morning, maybe 3:00 in the morning, and we're just about coming up to the end of our first 24 hours, and we've done 85 miles, which, given the wind direction, isn't that bad. And the wind is slowly shifting around to the south, as promised, although it was supposed to do it a long time ago. So we're making really good progress. For the first time, we are actually sailing in the direction we want to go, as opposed to having to beat. But it's been great. It's been really good. Looks turquoise.
Who's what?
The water looks really turquoise in the camera.
What?
Just keep the wind at right angles to that pole. So, that's better.
Better once you get off the point.
Maybe. You're working there, boy, weren't you? You're a little
bit more chance.
And it is?
It is. I'm not sure what it's called.
Pitta avec tomato.
Pitta and cheese. Roger?
I'll be having pitta not in a frying pan.
Oh, but raw.
It'll be raw.
Yeah, yeah.
That'll be because of my cousin married a Japanese girl.
Yeah.
And I'll be having some salami with a bit of chili pesto on the top. Yeah, don't call me cultured for nothing.
So, how was your first proper overnighter?
Very exhilarating, yeah.
Was
very,
it?
Very interesting, yeah. Very sort of high speed.
Would you do it again?
Yes, yeah.
You would?
Yeah, I do.
Would you do it another week?
Of course I would, mate. It's been the last surgery, so it's been quite exhilarating and funny. Yeah.
It's quite dull at times, and
yes.
Being perpetually sleep deprivated is
yes,
trying a quiet taste.
Yeah, having the sort of inner voice of I just want to go back to bed, but you can't because it's your turn. Yeah, that's been a bit hard, but yeah, it's been
The day shifts are easy, aren't they?
The night
ones are it's 1 o'clock in the morning and stuff.
Yeah, but all I can say is God bless the Dalek in the cockpit. And, without that. Yeah.
Well, I think it steers better than any of us, doesn't it?
Yes, it's good.
I've done some night sailing, kind of late ends and early starts, but nothing through the night. And we've done 3 nights and 4 days, so we're getting into the routine. Last night we had a really nice supper in the cockpit. The nights have been completely different. First night was a bit because it was windy and the wind was on the nose and there was a lot of traffic around. Second night was across the Thames. There's a lot of stuff around, but it's much more relaxed. The boat was going really well. Last night, apparently, I slept through it. We got becalmed. We started the night going about 3 knots with the wind behind us, and then we got becalmed, and now it's swung around to the north, ready for the storm that's coming. So, we we're doing 5.9 knots at the moment towards the mouth of the Humber. We've done 287 miles on the journey, maximum speed 10.4, no idea where that came from. Moving average is 4 knots, which is what we've been aiming for. It's been up and down a bit, but you know, 4 knots is pretty good. Obviously when the tide's with us, we're whizzing along at 5 knots, and then the tide's against us. The boat seems to be going, but we're getting 2.5 knots. Time moving, 71 hours. There's a storm coming, so we are heading for one of three refuges. Either Bridlington, which is a drying place, noisy, with birds and commercial traffic. I mean, with fishermen, it's quite a nice place. But it dries, so coming and going is a bit hard. Scarborough, which is a holiday town. It's okay, it's a pretty nice marina. Showers aren't that good, and but the ideal would be Whitby, which is a lovely marina, and it's got great showers and loos, brilliant showers and loos. It would be lovely, but Whitby is well, actually, at this speed, Whitby is only 13 hours away. So if we could keep this speed up, we could get to Whitby today, which would be great. 80 miles to Whitby. But you know, 5.9 knots, we're not really going to keep going at 5.9 knots. So, but we might do, you never know. There is a storm coming, so if there's a storm coming and the wind keeps up, we can keep the speed up. It's a bit on the nose at the moment. So it'd be better if it swung around to the west a little bit. A nice strong blow from the west, which kept us going at a decent speed, would be great. But you can't determine what the weather is going to do. So there are three havens ahead of us. And that, so that's without running. We've got to get across the mouth of the Humber, which is 3 hours away. There's quite a current flowing, isn't it?
Welcome to cooking.
Not enough space. You aren't actually filming this, are you?
Yeah.
All right.
Do all three at once.
There you go, fish.
Nice. Extreme cooking.
Oh, that's good.
All right.
Yeah.
We only do eight.
I do.
How far?
How far? 8 miles. We are, you know, we're giving a good account of ourselves.
We're doing okay. But...
Over.
lads out here, wouldn't you?
Yeah. Mm. He's caught a fish.
Oh, the orange one?
Yeah.
Where is he? Heading for the cliffs.
Yeah, let's go up, so let's just go up close to the socket. But let's stop just before so that we don't have it shining in through the windows. bit more forwards. Just bring the bow up to the socket there. Put your that's it, John, round that cleat. Brilliant.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Look, that seagull's been shitting on her arse. Oh, it's a man in shorts fishing, John.
Bye-bye, Scarborough.
Yeah, goodbye.
Bye-bye, Scarborough.
Right, shall I get the fence?
Yeah, I might as well before it gets rough. Doesn't look very good, does it?
Well, it doesn't look too rough to me, lads. What do you think?
Not rough at all.
Very attractive.
When we're really old, we could revisit Scarborough, couldn't we? We could get Roger to push us around in our dual wheelchair.
Yeah, you'd be your little American chopper mobility skills, yeah. A pair of you, weren't you? Like the two old boys off the Muppets, wasn't it?
Oh, remember when we were here last?
Yeah.
What was the name of that young lad? Oh, I'm sure I can remember it. He'll come to me in a minute.
Hacking around, running into students with your mobility scooters. Yeah. Up and down the hill into the Brunswick Centre.
I noticed we had a place to put four cans of special brew in the.
Yes, I say. Yeah.
Here's a good one. Looks like nothing at all on the film. This is steepy. No, we're not going to do that. When did we have our pills? It says 8 hours, it says. So we'll probably not overdo it. Meaningful journey, and we've been going for, we've been on a fetch in a grey world for getting on for 20 hours now. So, and we've probably got another 20 hours to go of this grey fetch to Anstruther. Now, as you know, people send me presents, which I'm very, very grateful for. And this arrived from Germany, from Chris Bulg. A Pelly case.
I still had in my spare pack box and I've never used. So use it for KTL or Harmony or eBay.
eBay?
I hope I can order soon a new DVD. Enjoy the summer. I have to go to work on a container ship all summer.
Wow, one of those.
Me.
Herringsfleet.
There's none of that dead fish.
Ruger Fischkalanka.
Oh, excellent.
Oh, I love fish. Yeah. Fine Lach Super. I think it's fish soup. Fine fish soup.
Easy additive. Have your Grottemar.
Grottemar. So we mix the gratamar with the herring. You could eat this raw. Should we have some of this now?
No, I'm alright.
Yeah. Come on.
Yeah, very good.
Look at this.
Wow.
Very practical man, Chris. I can see
No, it's fine. You're part of the shot. Yeah, there are some in the South Pacific.
tell me it now.
What's that?
About them looking like cobras.
Oh, just where the waves rise up. It looks like a cobra that's been poked with a stick. And they go, oh, like that.
We've got about another 22 hours of this.
Sorry. It's the DSC stick field and Luke's Lake.
Yeah. Says here it's 489 miles, so it's going to be pretty bang on 500 miles. Maximum speed 14.7 knots. I've no idea where that came from. Must have just been falling off a wave somewhere. Moving average 4.1 knots. I was aiming for 4 knots at moving average. Time moving 120 hours 38 minutes so far. Anstruther, 21 miles. It's been brilliant. I have to say it's been a lot of work to get this boat into the place where KTL was in February. Massive amount of work just to change boats, but it's been fun. I mean, you know, you only go around the hamster wheel of life once and you might as well enjoy what you do, and I've had a fantastic time. Still am having a fantastic time, and I really hope it's going to be a brilliant summer.
I'm just going to say that it's been a really good experience, and I'm now no longer frightened of sailing at night. I think it's been an astonishing thing. 500 miles in 6 days and four and a half nights.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Go for it. But yeah, very good. Very exciting. Yeah. Best bits, looking back on it now with hindsight, probably actually coming in here at full speed in the dark, looking for lights and channel marks.
With John catching every fourth one in the face.
I think you're mixing up best and most memorable bits.
Best bit, the whole trip, mate, without sounding too cliched, it's been pretty cool sailing with you two, so it's been good times.
Even though you called us the Muppets old men.
Yeah, you two are Waldorf, and I forget the other one. Yeah, the two old dudes that have... No, but yeah, pleasure, been pleasure. Really, really good.
So you're going to change your boat in any way as a result of this?
Probably just put a bigger rig on it than I've already designed, yeah. No, I shall keep the Centaur. I feel very, very safe in a Centaur in a six, gusting
I'm
seven.
Amazed that. Yeah.
North Sea, everything that it could throw at it, it just got its shoulder into it and didn't once feel at all unnerved or unwary.
I think the ability to reef the main from the cockpit would be a good thing, don't you?
I think that would probably be the only thing I'd change on your boat. But obviously, there's no point because of what the project is.
It wouldn't be a hard thing to do.
No, no, not at all. I mean, you could pretty much just bring one set of lines back to do that. But that would be the only thing. And that's what only worried me a bit when you were going up on deck.
It's
interesting seeing how much food we have left over, considering we've done this trip pretty much on energy bars.
I think that's the thing is, if you're going to keep going through the weather, as soon as it gets above a two, cooking becomes pretty much impossible.
Yeah, it's pointless, isn't it? It's just, so yeah, they'll ginger nut biscuits, cup of soups.
The ginger nuts work quite well. Stoudron worked.
Yeah. Stoudron, we give a big thumbs up.
John Hero never got sick.
Yeah, he was, he put Dylan and I to shame.
It was about 24-hour stint when I didn't really eat very much and didn't drink very much either.
Nah. I think we didn't drink enough for a while.
We didn't drink enough. I certainly didn't drink enough.
I had a headache and the shakes after when we left Scarborough. I think it was just dehydration, powered up again. Yeah.
Sleeping was good though. I thought I slept amazingly well. I was amazed. I thought I wasn't going to sleep.
And I'm really surprised we slipped into the sort of watch system so easily and then slipped out of it and then turn and turn about in the berth. I mean, none of the berths were the back here were unlivable on either tack. You could get yourself easily wedging. This idea of I was a bit nervous about this sort of being tucked underneath here, but actually. It was great. You could lock yourself in position.
Yeah,
you went
exactly,
to sleep.
Yeah.
You just went to sleep. So it was not a problem at all.
Yeah.
No, I really enjoyed it. It's been really, really good.
Just sit there and doze.
Yeah. Telepilot.
Just watch.
I mean, you've introduced us to something completely.
Yeah, that was interesting because the first night you guys didn't trust it, did you?
No,
yeah.
No, no,
you thought, evil technology.
I'm gonna go right the way through my 2-hour watch doing this.
Yeah, they'll pop
my
arm.
And then next watch, Dylan's going, what's the problem? It was an adventure. It was an adventure. And you were right about the adventure. You've got to have the odd time in an adventure where you think, I don't really want to be here.
And when you were sitting on the foredeck?
I never had a chance to put my gloves on. There's nothing to hang on to. I've got no safety lanyards. And that's another bucket full of seawater I'm just having in my face. You couldn't put anything down to zip up.
That was easily, for me, coming in here was the worst bit of the trip.
And I was thinking, they're not going for the right lights. They're not going for the right lights.
Now, you've made a terrible accusation. I am hyperactive.
You are. Dylan Winter is ADHD.
It's obviously your way of coping with a particular situation.
Yes.
Not
to move faster, but to adjust whatever's going on.
Yes.
Whether it's the race.
So you think that my sail trims were unnecessary?
They were very necessary when the weather was up, but when we were going backwards at half a knot, I kind of thought they were a little bit pointless. When we were becalmed. What I would term a cruising sailor, you are very, it's your inner racer,
I don't like it running inefficiently.
That's absolutely fine, yeah, but I've just never been on a cruising boat where somebody's constantly adjusting Genoa cars and trim angles, and that's, like I say, that's how you get somewhere quick, that's how you get somewhere fast, but it was quite funny to watch when we were just sitting there reading books. And
we averaged 4.1 knots, which isn't actually bad. Hyperactive, I never
thought. No, you are. You're quite,
the most chilled, laid back.
Yeah, you are
man.
Quite.
I don't shout though, do I?
No. That was the other thing getting used to on about is not being barked at. Yeah.
You kind of declined the position of captain, didn't you?
Yeah, we kept calling you skipper. You didn't like that.
I just
turned the guy who owns the boat.
You carried on, regardless.
Yeah,
you kept on right to the last fucking minute.
If I want to get to Dylan, I'm just going to call it
skipper. Skipper, what do you want for breakfast? Stop it.
So was this, I asked it on one of the forums, how would you characterise the management style?
The route, but certainly, sail trim, engine on, engine off decisions. Yeah, we all pretty much sort of sat round and had a chat, didn't we? And decided your way was the right way.
So that's the odd thing.
Just keep him occupied. I'll come to the catalogue. No, I was like, no, it was pretty good. We all were.